let us understand why in the first place one has hemifacial spasms. The reason lies in neurovascular conflict in majority of the cases. Now, there are some exceptions. 2% to 3% do not have this conflict. They have multiple sclerosis or some other disorders, which obviously we diagnose first and we do not offer microvascular decompression for them. But in majority of the patients, the cause is the neurovascular conflict. What does it mean? It means that the facial nerve, which comes out of the brain just above the medulla oblongata and below the pons, that is pontomedullary junction, that is brainstem, and then comes out and then supplies one part of the face, it is getting continuously compressed by a blood vessel inside the skull, of course, but it is getting compressed by a blood vessel. Why does it happen in these patients? Because their anatomy is as such, their size of the posterior fossa or the space where the nerve lies, specific blood vessel shape is such that starting from the birth, the blood vessel is precariously near the nerve. As the age advances, the blood vessels, they become elongated, they become long. Now, this happens in everybody. For example, if you look at an elderly person's hand, you will see a tortuous vessel. As the age advances and the vessel is elongating, what will it do? It will slowly burrow itself into the facial nerve. And where is this happening? It is happening inside the skull, that is near the brain stem. As it is progressively burrowing itself in the root entry zone of the facial nerve, it will start imparting its pulsations, because blood vessels, that is arteries, have pulsations. In brain, even veins have significantly strong pulsations. So these are the pulsations hitting on the nerve. Okay. Now, these pulsations are causing damage to the nerve over the period of time, and they cause demyelination. Or in simple words, let's say they remove coating from individual nerve fibers. So there is a short circuiting. It is called as demyelination. Now, this demyelination causes these hemifacial spasms. So it's a pulsatile compression. It is not only compression, but it is pulsatile. Do you understand what I am saying? It is a pulsatile hammer-like compression of facial nerve. The compression is increasing inside because the blood vessel is elongating. As you can see in this particular video, there is a blood vessel which is compressing the facial nerve, and the patient comes to the hemifacial spasm center with moderate symptoms. So let's say this is a day zero or day one, and this blood vessel is continuously pulsating against the nerve, causing demyelination. The spasms are slowly increasing in nature. Suppose the patient doesn't do anything at this point of time, just waits or takes Botox to mask the spasms. After 6 months or 8 months, blood vessel will elongate further and then burrow inside the nerve even further. Here, the spasms would have become severe. Let's say still the patient doesn't do anything about it. So we will land up with this kind of a situation. Extremely ectatic, very, very tortuous vessel which is compressing the facial nerve, causing severe nerve damage, distortion of the nerve, as you can see here. Some of these symptoms can be so severe that the face continuously remains contracted on one side for 30 seconds, 40 seconds. So this is what we call as a very severe state.
A person is not able to face the society. Person is not able to go to different social functions, cannot go for, young people cannot go for interviews, they cannot enjoy life, they cannot get married, they cannot do their job properly. Just imagine a front desk employee who has hemifacial spasms and she has to talk to the customers continuously. So how embarrassing it would be. So this embarrassment is not only cosmetic. It starts taking hold of the entire psyche and the person becomes depressed. So this is a chain. You know, they are not just momentary spasms. Some of the patients have told me that, doctor, even my relatives have not understood me, because they say, oh, these are some flickers you get sometimes. That's all right. Let them happen. But I am suffering as a person. I am going in my shell. I am becoming depressed. I am not able to enjoy life. I feel embarrassed. So sometimes I feel that life is not worth living. So some people, that is exactly 12 people out of 220 plus MVDs done for hemifacial spasms, have told us that at some point of time they had contemplated suicide. Now this is how it actually tarnishes your confidence. So that is the reason why I say that people have to be guided properly. My MVD surgery or microvascular decompression surgery is the only available technique through which these spasms can be stopped. And this is what I have been telling at our center continuously. Please be aware of these facts. If you have such problems, do not hesitate to call us. We will guide you. Final decision is always the patient's decision. But do not be misinformed or ill-informed. Please help us spread this message in the society about the signs, symptoms, treatment, options, modalities, and cure possibilities of hemifacial spasms and trigeminal neuralgia. Thank you very much for listening, and I hope you have got important information through this video.